Okay, we're gonna get started. We're gonna put a this is gessoed a couple times. Square canvas for the drips CD. We're gonna be doing some extra stuff too. I'll just let you look. This is I'm using mostly metallics. This is house paint with Floetrol in it. I'm just gonna lay down a base coat. This is a wooden angel. Wooden angel cutout. I think that's enough. Gotta love gold. Okay, that's enough. You see, chunky. Nice. Okay, what is that? A little chunky. So to me, this type of painting, I came from a painting background, abstract, but this type of art is really like a movement. So many people doing it. It's just like so addicting and so fun. I just want to make sure I get those angel, the wings there. Okay, so now I'm kind of mixed media, really. sorry, guys. Okay. So this is just a plastic thing, but I want a circle there. So I'm going to give this a shot. I think right there. You guys can see, right? Oh, not too good. Let's see. Back that way. Okay. And I think that right there. Okay, so I've got to pour the paint, mix the paint, whatever. Okay. I even got string over here. String. May do something with that too. Okay, so I love this too. Look, $2. PPG, metallic. Oh, it's so beautiful. You will see. I think my other videos I've used this around Valentine's Day or before it. I don't know how much to pour. What is going for it? What is that? Oh. You know, I believe in the messy but beautiful. And I meant to put silicone thought. I put it right there as it comes out. Oh, probably too much. Let's take some of it out. There you go. Okay. Now, this is metallic black. I let it sit for a while. This has been sitting for a while. It's making cells. You guys see that on there? Oh my goodness, it's beautiful. Okay. This is fairly good. Okay. I guess it's okay to have some of the thicknesses different, but black goes a long way. You see, I did a small thing of it. And then I got this parchment color. I thought it was like, when I bought it, this is Artist Loft, these two, with Floetrol. I thought this was like bleached white, but that's okay. It looks like unbleached titanium, I meant. think I put a lot of that. I have no idea about how much I need. What have you? But I'm gonna put a little more gold. This flight was given to me from like a professional painter that trained me here full time. He is. He had been given it. It's like expensive paint from Ralph Lauren or somebody like that. Anyway, it's nice. Hopefully no chunkies. Oh, I was bubbling up. I will show you. A little bit of black. Little. Okay, some of the bleached white. Parchment. I suppose it's different. Looks like newspaper. Looks like the newspaper print color. Like, I don't know if anybody reads that stuff anymore. Okay. Okay, maybe that's enough. Okay. Now we're going to swirl this around a little bit. I'm not sure there's enough paint. That's like half a cup. It's like going down. It's like going down. I think I should put some white in it. I had some white mix up from earlier. I did a pour. It's drying over here. I have so many, guys. We're in that space. We're not going to go with the white. Okay, so this is looking really good. So here we go. Get the gas stick. Okay, mix that a little bit. Here we go. So we'll go over here. Okay, I'll go back down. Back down there again. Oh, this is looking nice. When I started doing this, like, was 2-3 years ago, there was, like, hardly anybody doing this, paint pouring. It's like a movement. I love it. I feel like I'm in a movement now. Okay. Looks like enough paint. Okay, so we're going to go like this. Hope you guys can see this. Oof. Gotta love it. Then you can peel that off too, at the bottom. Make paint skins. I'm gonna use it for mixed media stuff. Oh, and you gotta love Mixed Media Girl. Shout out. And she's good. Let's see who else. Wizzle Art. I love him. Lots of people. Oof. Looks so good on the sides. Okay. Please. Just cover it all. Please. Right. Okay. Now I gotta check for chunkies. Maybe it's gonna be like a flower. Okay. Oof. Selling up. Look at that. Ah, I dripped there. Okay, so we're gonna do something here. The corner. I think that's enough. Maybe. Okay, I want to save a little bit. Now we're going to take this off. Or should I brush it down? So you always want to use the brush because it came from that kind of background. Or where I started. Looks pretty though, right? Oh, looks good on there. Plus, I like to get every little bit of paint. Okay, put this in the water thing that's off camera. What do you think? I don't know. It's going to get muddy, right? It's going to get muddy. So I'm going to lift it off. Okay. Nice. Not crazy about that spot in there. Kind of got slippery. Not crazy about that. Okay, let's get this corner. I kind of wanted a flower, like. Let's do something here. Close it off. Leave it alone. There we go. Okay, I'm not too crazy about that, but we're gonna. Where's my palette knife? I'll just use this. You just gotta go quick decisions sometimes. Okay, I'm liking it. I'm liking it. So now I'm gonna lift this wing up. Hopefully, I don't drop it. And I have good stuff on something. Got something ready. Ready, Freddy. Okay, that's ready, Freddy. Hi. Okay, here we go. Okay. I feel like just leaving it. Just going right there. Wow, I really covered that. Proud of myself. Let me just get a couple. Please retain some of the flowers, some of the roundness. I like roundness. Okay, you can use a torch or you can use something to pop something. Pop the bubbles. Not too many bubbles in them. Very good. Floetrol works like a champ. Let it drip. Drippity drip. Oh, that round one's cool. Stay flat. Oh, I want more drip. Okay. Let's see. Stick some of that out. But this little cell's coming up. I'm not crazy about cells, but they're right. They have roundness and stripes. But I would like some cells running in there. It's kind of thick. See, it's thick. The doggy's doing something. Okay. I guess bubbles would be dripping. Okay, I'm about to put this on. Gotta leave it alone. Gotta leave it alone at a certain point. Just leave it alone. And I'm gonna leave it alone after I cover this corner. This rounded corner. I love doing this rounded stuff. Instead of rectangles all the time. Okay. I think it's good. It's good, good, good. But I'm gonna okay. Okay, you guys wanna see? Coming out nice. We'll see how it dries. I see dripping. I see it dripping. Okay, so there's one here. Should dry and drip. Make sure it's flat, guys. Flat. Kind of psychedelic, right? Okay, so let's finish this. Doggies are playing. I think as is. Maybe a little bit of swirling. For all you cell lovers. That's a lot. Of course, I have tape on there too, so it's going to come out even different than that. Let's see if I see any bubbles or anything. Also, the trick to no bubbles is I heard from, I think, Gina DeLuca on YouTube. Few drops of alcohol, rubbing alcohol. I'm using, like, she uses 90%. I'm using, like, 50% from the dollar store, you know. Guess I'm going to let that dry, too. Look, I have nowhere to put this either. Oh, my God. Okay, we're going to put it right back here. Right back here. Hopefully, I will not mess it up by moving it. Okay, we got to do this one. Okay, I'm not too happy about what I did there. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Okay, do we have any more paint before it freaking dries in there? Because this side's got to be covered. Don't gotta be, but you know the sides. This is like gallery wrapped. This is like, but I get on sale. From good old Michaels. I gotta be patient and let it drip down. I'm not patient. God, the rest of the sides are gonna look fabulous. Fabulous, darling. Oh, see? Get through there. Oh, I can see my hair. But it does look good. Okay, so I'm gonna put this down. Can't even see that. Well, you see a little bit of the parchment color. See? You see it, guys? Always, always make sure the freaking corners. There's one guy that has these rounded, which I have one that I'm gessoing that's a round. Big round piece of wood that I just purchased. And it's gessoing. Probably have to sand it too. Oh, this one's lovely. Maybe I should leave it like that. Leave one side like that. Maybe I will. Okay. Let's use a torch to get some more cells. Maybe. It's like webbing in the middle there. It's nice. I like it. I'm gonna have cells. I like little ones. Look at there. That's kind of a heart. You guys see that? Right here. Right there. I always see hearts in my paintings that I sometimes don't put there. It just comes out, which is sweet. Okay, I'm loving this. Okay, guys. Maybe that's like, maybe something. It's like, okay. A little part right there. It's like a little bit of paint. I think that some Ethicone stuff, blaster stuff, helped it slide on out of there. Okay, this is great. I think it's great. But I didn't lift that, did I? I never did lift this one. A little bit. Oh, see? Oh, man. Oh. Okay. But it's still cool on the sides. See, look at the heart shape coming. We can use a skewer and make it a heart. Sounds pretty much there. You can maybe define it even more. Oh my goodness, there's some black in there. You guys are probably laughing like heck with me. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that's good. Very good. Torch again. Okay, guys, tell me what you think. Messy, but beautiful stuff here. Okay, guys, thanks a bunch.